Hello! In this video I will show you what I achieved within 200 days of solo developing my own indie dream game. Let's go! Let's start from the beginning. I have developed a start menu that shows a scene from the game in the background. I think it looks very beautiful, also because you can see the leaves blowing in the wind very well. The settings button doesn't have a function yet and it won't have one until shortly before the end of the project, and it's not a priority for me. When you click on the load button, you're sent to the loading screen and the game loads the last save game. If you haven't played yet, it will say something like start new game instead of load game. I have also built a complete day-night cycle into my game. A day lasts 24 minutes, as I simply took the real-time seconds as minutes for my game. A very common strategy to create a day-night cycle. The changes here are that the skybox can be in 4 different states: morning, noon, evening and night. The transition lasts 1 minute in-game and has a smooth transition, so it is hard to notice the change of the skybox at all. What helps with the illusion is the light, which also changes according to the skybox, as well as the fog in the distance, which also changes the color. I'm actually quite happy with the system. What is also noticeable is that the shadow in the game world adapts with the time, so that here too a sun is imitated that rotates around the game world. You can pick up items that you find in the game world. These are placed in a separate inventory. The inventory can display tooltips for the respective item and also has a gold count at the bottom left. I think the inventory feels very good due to responsive UI. The inventory is more like a dashboard because you can switch between the tabs for crafting and quests. But I think the whole design aspect of the UI is totally awful. I think I need to tackle this point at some time. It really looks awful. Of course, you can find items anywhere on the map, but you can also gather some by destroying resources in the game world. You can destroy all kinds of materials like stones or trees. With each hit, a damage indicator will tell you how much damage you have dealt to the target object. When the object is destroyed, you get your resource like stones or wood or acorns. Acorn can be planted so you can grow your own trees again. There is currently a bow system in the making, but it doesn't look that good. There are some physics formulas missing to make it look a bit more realistic and more fun to play. Also, the rotation at the start where the arrow spawns. And there's no animation, but we come to that point later. I also did some work on the sound design. Quite everything is still missing, especially a soundtrack for the background that fills the silence, but so far I'm quite happy actually with the few elements I have already. Have a listen for yourself. The crafting system is super basic. We just check if we have the correct amount of right items needed for the crafting object, and then we can easily craft this specified item with a simple button click. I didn't want to be crafting a super big factor in my game, but also I did not want to rob the user with the fun of creating some more items if they need something. I also did not want to implement something like a shopkeeper or something else, so you can adventure the island and search for items you need and craft them for yourself. You can destroy some objects with attacks like the bow or a sword or even with a pickaxe, but you can also go on a hunt with these items. The animal kinda looks very stiff right now, but hey, it's working, I count that as a success. I also built a dialogue system so that you can talk to NPCs. In this case it's still a cube because I don't have any 3D models of NPCs or even my own player yet because my modeling skills suck. Nevertheless, the system can display any number of text panels and with a mouse click you can move on to the next text panel. If the dialogue is too long, you can simply move away and the dialogue ends. This is actually a cool solution if players are not interested in the story. Next to these bigger features, there's plenty of smaller stuff I can show what happened in the past 200 days. Like the immersive signpost, which prints its text right into the 3D world when reducing the distance to it. Or the butterflies and the leaves flying around. The post-processing that makes everything looks more beautiful, or the birds in the sky traveling from one point to another, or the design of the city or even the whole game world, but I think this goes beyond the scope of this video. If you're interested in how I managed all the things, I added a playlist where you can binge all of my devlogs to see how this is made. There's still a lot missing before the game is really playable, but I'll be honest with you, solo indie game development is hard. My motivation to turn the game into a real AAA title is not that high anymore. Well, that's hard to do alone. But I think I'll reduce the scope of this title again so that the game is finally finished. The feeling of finishing a game is important, and I've rarely had that feeling because I've always seen new shiny objects and always created new side projects of side projects. I don't want to create a new side project here either, even though I have some really cool new ideas. So the game plan for the future looks like this. I want to create 3 to 4 character models with animation, which will then represent the player and NPCs. I want to incorporate the already written story into the game world. All unnecessary features will be removed from the game for the time being, especially for the UI. Known bugs will be fixed, and the soundtrack for the game gets created. Once all this is done, the game will be halfway playable and thus finished for me for the time being. Don't worry, it will still take a long time, but just to give you a heads up. I also want to publish my game on itch.io so that everyone can play it. I will not release it on Steam. And yeah, that's about it. If you want to know how I programmed it all, you can watch this playlist right now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this video, or dislike the video if you didn't like it. I'm out.